Hello everyone, in this video I'll be explaining you how our Ionic Firebase Restaurant CMS dashboard works. So let's get started. But before that, in case if you're new here, please consider subscribing because we'll be discussing lot of things about our products. So if you want more information about our products, you can visit us on the website www.ionicfirebaseapp.com. So once you visit to our website, you can see here, you can see there is lot many products available here. So today I'll be explaining you our restaurant CMS dashboard. Today I'll be showing you the live demo as well. So once you go here, there is a live demo option available. So you have to just log in. You have to give your credentials like email and password, and you have to log in over here. And this is how our Ionic Firebase Restaurant dashboard looks like. So there are lots many features are available. I'll be explaining you one by one. First of all, there is a home feature, whereas you can fetch all the details about your menu items, categories, and if at all, if any customer orders for you, it will be coming for the admin dashboard. So you can access how many orders you have got, and you can access the product sales report as well. So this is all about the home page. And next, if you click on categories, so you can also add the categories for your restaurant. You have to just go to here at the top right corner, there is a add category option. So you have to just click on it and you have to type a category, for example, vegetable. So you have to just give a quick description about that. You have to give a quick description and you can give it briefly also. After that, you have to upload some image, how the category looks like, and you have to just click on add category. Once you click on add category, your category has been added successfully and it will be appearing for the user in order to select from the category options. So this is how the category works. And if at all, if you want to edit some category, here there is a edit option available. You have to just click on it and you can edit the things, and you have to, if at all you want to choose a different file, you can choose it from here and you have to just click on upload category. Once you click on upload category, it will be updated successfully. And here there is a view option. If you click on it, you can see all the details from here. This is how the category option works. And if at all, if you want to delete some categories, you can delete from here. There is a delete option. It will ask yes, delete it, and it will get deleted. So next, there is a menu item. So once you go to the menu items, you can also add different menu items. If at all, if some menu is new to your restaurant and you want other customers to take it, and you can try it. You can, if at all, if you have tried some new items, you can go to add new item. Click on add new item. And you can fill in all the details. And if at all, if you have any offers available in order to provide for the customers as well, you can also give the offers as well on that particular menu items. And you can select the categories, like whatever the category you have created over there. For example, in the category page, category feature, you have to just select it, whichever the category your menu items belongs to. So I'll be selecting vegetable. And if at all, if there is any extra ingredients you want to add, like extra vegetable, then you can add a price as well. You can add a price as well, And here, if at all, if you want to add it extra, so you can just click on this icon and you can add it from there. You have to just click on it. Here you can add from here. That's it. If at all if you want to delete it, you can delete from this delete option. The next thing is you can add a size for it. Size like standard, full or off or anything. Standard size for it, and you have to give the rupees, how much amount, price, and you have to upload the picture. For the demo purpose, I'll be showing you. You have to upload the picture, whichever you want to add to menu items, and you have to just click on sub. Once you click on submit here, see, you can see whatever the menu items you have added here, it's displaying here. I had added a menu items of the price 150 with an offer of 50%. So if at all if you click on view option, you can see all the details, whatever the menu items you have added. If at all if you want to edit it, you can just go to this edit option and you can edit it as well. So this is, and once you edit it, you have to click on submit option. This is how your menu items works. And next important feature is currency. You can also set a currency for your products. Products in your restaurant. You have to just go to add currency and you have to type here whatever the currency you want to add, and here you have to add a currency symbol, and here there is a currency symbol list. You have to just click on it, and here there are lot many symbols available. In once you scroll down, there is a lot many symbols, and you can paste this symbol over there. See, you can see lot many symbols are available. You can place any of the symbols, whatever you wanna wish here, and you have to just click on add currency. Once you click on add currency, whatever the currency you have added, it is appearing here. You can have a look of it. And if at all if you want to edit it, you can go here and you can edit it. And if at all if you want to delete it, you can go here and you can delete it easily. And next feature is order page. Once you go to the orders, you can see all the order details of the customer who have ordered your products, like menu items and whatever the food they wanna like. So you can access all the details, what's the name of the customer, their email and your phone number, and you can also change the status from here. Once a user, once the customer orders any items, you can change the status, whether it's pending, whether it's on the way, whether it's cancelled or delivered. Once it's delivered, you can change the status as well. So it's on the way means you can change the status as on the way. What are the status you have changed here, it will be appearing for the customer. So it will be helpful for them to have a track of the items, what's happening and all. So the next feature is table booking. Once the customer books a table, it will be coming to the dashboard. So you can assign a table for them. You can assign a table number and you can assign the table status as well, whether the table is available or whether it's cancelled or something like that. You can approve it as well. Once the customer books a table, you can do this, and you can also view the details from here, details of the customer, what's the name, email ID and phone number, etc, etc, and all the details you also you can view. This is all about the table booking. And next feature is coupons. You can also set a coupon for the customer, for the users. So if at all if you want to wish to give any of the offers for the customer, you can give it from here. So you have to just go to add coupon and you have to give a coupon title. I'll be giving exciting offers. And you can give a percentage, how much percent off you want to give to them. I'll be giving 50%. So if at all the item costs around 100 rupees, if at all if you give 50% off, it will be coming around 50 rupees. So this is how it works. So if at all if you want to wish, you can just give all the details here and you have to just click on submit. Once you click on submit, whatever the coupon you have given, it will be appearing. And if at all, if you want to delete it, you can delete it as well. Say suppose tomorrow you don't want to give this offer for them, so that you can delete it from the delete option given below. Next thing is, you can also add a tag. You have to just click on add tag, and you have to enter a tag name, and you have to just click on submit option given here. Once you do that, see here, your tag had been added successfully. So you can edit it, and also you can delete it if according to your wish. And next feature is users. So once you go to users, your users detail, complete details will be present here. What's your name, email ID, phone number. And you can also view from the view symbol over here. That's all about the users. And next thing is push notification. You can also send a push notification for your customers. So you can send a push notification. And once you type all these messages, you can just click on send option over here. See, notification has been sent successfully. This is how the push notification works. If at all, if you want to cancel it, you can cancel it as well. And next thing is news. You can add various news related to your item as well as your restaurant. For example, if you want to add some news about the one of the favorite customer favorite food of your restaurant, you can just click on add new category, and you have to fill in all the details about which you want to add a title, about the maybe one of the menu items, and author. You have to give the author, and you have to select a category, in which category it's present, and you have to just give a short description and description, and that upload that image, and you have to just click on this add news option, so that the news will be added successfully, and even the customer can access the news from the user app. The next important feature is delivery options. You can also set various delivery options to which point of location your order can be delivered. So you have to just go to add pin, and you have to just give the pin code to whichever the location your item can be ordered, and you have to just click on submit option. Your delivery point is added successfully. You can have a look over here. And next feature is loyalty. You can also set a loyalty points from here. You have to just set a loyalty points, and you have to just click on save. And you can also edit the business information, so that it will be very useful for the customer, so that they can take it from business information. If you set here, it will be available for the customer at any point of time. If they have any queries, or if they have any comment, or if they have any suggestion, they can give it to you. If at all, if you upload these business details, maybe your email ID or address, or Facebook link, Twitter link, everything, it will be helpful for them. So you have to fill in all the details, and you have to just click on submit option over here, so that it will be very helpful. And next important feature is settings, so that you can set a different settings over here. You can change the restaurant image according to your wish, and you can change the restaurant icon, and you can also add the currency as well. So to what if the currency your product is been available, and you have to set all these things, and you have to just click on save option. And once you click on save option, your settings will be updated successfully. And next important feature is chat option. Whenever the customer have any queries, they'll be asking you via chat. So one of my customer had sent me a message, "Hi, I need modification in my current order." So you can reply them back, "Yes, I can help you out. I can help you out with that." You can just reply them. So this reply will be going for them. So this is also one of the important features and very very important. And next thing is you can also add the testimonials. So to add the testimonials, you have to just click on add new testimonials, and you have to fill in all the details, what's the name, what's the company name, and what's a short description and everything. And you can also add the picture, and you have to just click on add testimonials option over here, and your testimonials will be added successfully. And next feature is you can also see the number of subscribers for your particular item, I mean product. You can also see the subscribers. This is all about the different features of our Ionic Firebase CMS dashboard, and this is how you can configure all the settings, it may be category, menu items, and every important features. So this is how this is all about our restaurant CMS app. So in case if you have other questions as well, I highly recommend you to post down on the comment section given below, and we'll be surely making a video for that. With this, I'll say that if you are enjoying this video in here, make sure that you will be giving a thumbs up. In case if you are new here, consider subscribing, and if you think that this video is really helpful for somebody, make sure that you share it, and I will be surely catching you up in the next video. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys. Bye bye.